Hey guys, welcome to the first of many videos. I'm gonna kind of dedicate this channel also to my car audio stuff. So I've been doing some car audio stuff on the side versus my normal job. And I love doing it, it's so much fun. So a lot of the projects that I'm gonna be doing in with my car audio stuff, I'm gonna post on this channel. So this is the first one, so far, so I'm gonna show you what we're doing. So I've got a Jeep Wrangler TJ, as you see here. This thing is a beast. I mean, it's got upgraded bumpers, you can see some upgrade lift stuff, wheels, tires. Obviously it's been looks like rhino lined or bed lined on part of it. It's got the big upgraded spare. Jeep's pretty nice, but what we're doing with this one is he said when he has the top off that he cannot, the speakers just are not very good. You can't hear them and everything like that. So I suggested we'll just replace all the speakers. So we're gonna replace these front dash speakers. We're also gonna replace the roll bar speakers. And he said he wanted a new radio because he said this one is not very good. Plus it's also droopy and kind of, if you can see that, it's kind of loose. So we're gonna replace that. All speakers, but we're also going to add an amplifier to these speakers to push a little more power. So I'll show you what we got. So for the speakers, I suggested doing some kickers. So they're usually pretty powerful and they're not that expensive, because he said he didn't really want to break the bank on this. So I suggested some kickers. So we'll put these up front and these will be in the roll bar. And then we got an amplifier to push these back speakers a little more. And then also we have a Pioneer, a radio. He said the main two things that he wanted was Bluetooth and a detachable face. So that is exactly what this one does. So we're gonna upgrade everything with all this stuff. All right, first things first is we're gonna replace these dash speakers just cause they're really easy. And then I'll start by wiring in that amp. So first thing, all you gotta do is just take off, there's two screws here and here. Just take that off and then you'll see the speaker. Alrighty, so here's the speaker that is in here. It looks like it's an old school Boston Audio in the factory, I don't know what you call it, the factory little speaker housing thing with also the factory little tweeter that comes on here. So I'm gonna pop this thing out and then I'll show you what we need to do with the front dash speakers with the new mounting bracket. Okay, first things first. When I install speakers, I do not like to cut and splice unless I absolutely just have to. So a lot of the times when you're just replacing speakers, there'll be harnesses like this. Usually Metra makes them that you can just literally just plug into the speakers on this end and then plug into the factory harness, which is exactly how I like to do it. Cause you know, I don't want to try to disrupt anything that's on their factory wise, if that makes sense. So I like to get harnesses and stuff like that, just so I don't have to cut and splice a bunch of wires together. And then also on the front speakers, I got the 4x6 cause I don't like to do like this, because you still have this factory tweeter that isn't very good and you get a much larger speaker with this. So I got the 4x6 kickers here. They will have to mount into this bracket here, through, you know, these tiny holes, if you can see those right there. And then these will mount into the factory location. So a little advice with these, obviously you can see how big those holes are and then how big the screws are. So my advice would be get a drill so that kind of start them with a screwdriver, get them in there straight and then drill them in. It just makes it a lot easier instead of trying to hand tighten those huge screws into these tiny holes with a hand screwdriver. So just some advice. Okay, I got my speakers out and everything that comes with the speakers. So you get obviously two speakers. You also get some screws for mounting, and then you'll get a couple wires, and you can see the ends of these you'll have to like splice into. So we'll actually not even use these. And then you also got some connectors here. So we actually won't be using any of this stuff because of our plug and play, and then also our speaker drills come with these screws, so we'll be using those. And then obviously we'll be using the factory screws to get these mounted in. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these mounted to the speaker grills and then I'll come back. Okay, well, we've had a development. Apparently this is a different plug than the harness that I ordered. So we're gonna need to cut this off and splice into it and use our wires that our speakers came with. So that kind of sucks, but you know, it is what it is. All right, kicker speaker is in there. We'll go ahead and test and see, make sure she works. You know, this would have been like a 5-minute process if I had the right cables.
Our family at Knoxville TVA Employees Credit Union, we wished you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
And she works.
Fairly insured by NCUA.
All right, we got both speakers in. Let's turn her up. They sound great. You can hear a little static, but that's because we're inside and it's just the radio playing. I don't have my phone plugged in or anything like that. But now I'm going to work on trying to get the amplifier wired up, because that's probably the next hardest thing to do. So I'm gonna do that next, because I like doing hard stuff first. I just wanted to get those speakers in just because they're like super, super simple. So let's start on the amp. Okay, here's the amp we got. It's a Planet Audio AC2000.2. It's a 2-channel, it is 2000 watts. So it should be definitely have plenty of power for what we need. So I'm gonna unbox this and see what all it comes with. All right, got it opened up. Of course, we got our paperwork and a sticker, which is lovely. We'll throw that to the side. You got the amplifier here. Here's what it looks like on this side. All of your adjustments and your RCA plugins. And of course, this side's gonna have all of your speaker plugins and your power and ground and all that. And then it came with this cable for the adjuster for your subs. We probably will not be using this just because it's, you know, it's speakers. And then obviously mounting screws, and then this little harness. I want to say this is for like a high frequency output. Let me see. Yeah, high level inputs, that's what it's for. Probably won't be using that either. So let's get started on this sucker. Okay, I had a little development. You can see my power cord right here. I wired it in right here. It's going straight to the battery right there. I dropped it down, got it just hanging down. I'm thinking I'm gonna go right through here. I don't know if y'all can see those. There's two holes right there. It's where the original seat bracket bolted in, I believe. So the wire just barely fits in there. I think that's a good place to kind of throw it in. I think I'm gonna go for this bottom one so the wire isn't sticking out, because the bright blue wire. So I'm gonna stick it through that bottom hole right there. Next, I've got the amp mounted. So it's mounted in there. It's in there good and solid. I hate amp companies that make these. I don't know if you can see that. Let me grab my light here. That make the holes deep like that, because you can't, you know, see where you need to drill and stuff like that. It's hard to mark where you need to drill, and they don't give you like self-tapping screws, so it's kind of difficult. But I've got it in there now, so I'm gonna run the power wire and all that good stuff. Okay, little update. I've got some stuff done. I have got ground on, power's on. I've got remote wire on the amp, which I'm gonna run that way to the back of the radio. And then I'm gonna plug in the RCAs here, plug those in, run them that way, and pretty much just put them in the driver floorboard, because I'm gonna do the radio last. So I'm gonna get those plugged in and run them that way, and then I'm gonna start replacing these. Alrighty, got the roll bar speakers out. Looks like he's got some Skosh speakers. If you look here on the back, I like how it actually gives you this stuff. So he said it was hard to hear. So you got 160 watts peak and 40 watts RMS. I got the kickers here. They're 225 watt max, 75 watt RMS. So these will be a definitely a big upgrade, plus the amp to push some more power. So I'm gonna get ready to wire these in. So here we go. All right, didn't film the process, but the passenger side speaker is in, and I've got the wire ran to the amp, or down towards the amp. I don't have it quite down there yet, but it is time to get that wired in, get this side wired into the amp so that I can see how much speaker wire I have for the other side, because I think I might need to go get some more, so we'll see. All right, I'm at a good spot right here, so I'm gonna take you on a little walk around here. So front speakers in the dash, done. Those are all good to go. Like I said, put the this is my power cable for the amp. I got it bolted on right there and ran down through here and at a good spot right here. Like, it's completely hidden behind the frame. I don't know if y'all can see that or not, but here, let me turn on a flashlight. You can see the tip of it going in right there. And I will come back here where the amp is all set up and good. Right there is where she's coming through. And then all my ground wire, remote wire, speaker wires, I'll get that all somewhat tidied up. RCAs are ran, also speaker wires are run up through here underneath the roll pad. So kickers up top are both in. So we're good to go to start on the radio. So that should not take me too long. I'll give you an update in a sec. Okay, here's the new radio. It's a Pioneer. Like I said, all he wanted was a detachable face and Bluetooth, which is, this has both. I recommended getting one with a USB and an aux jack just because, you know, it's an easier way to hook up your phone. Right there is the model number, if anybody wants to take note of that. Pretty good looking unit, but like I said before, I like to do things, you know, the right way. So we're not going to be, you know, snipping off the factory harness and then straight wiring this in. I do have this Metra harness right here that we're going to be wiring onto the radio harness, and then we'll just plug it in. So I've already looked inside his dash to make sure that it's going to be that I can just unplug the old radio and then plug this harness in, and it's good to go. So I'm just going to go ahead and wire this in. Okay, this may look like a wiring mess, but pretty much all you have to do is just connect the same colors. I usually make sure that the wiring diagram for the harness that you bought plus the one for the radio, make sure that the colors are going to the same thing. So like your right rear positive speaker, make sure it's the same thing on your other harness. Usually it is, but I just like to make sure, because my luck, it would be something different and I'd have it screwed up somehow. So this is all wired together. I'm going to take the old radio out, throw this one in, and that should be it. We're getting close. Okay, I apologize I didn't film anymore. I just kind of wanted to get it done. She is done. So you can see, here's the factory radio. I'll unplug this. Not the factory radio, why did I say that? Here's a new radio, nicely installed. Looks great in there. Also, kicker speakers. And then he has an aftermarket seat, so we're gonna lift this up. And we got the nice new amp all wired in. I'm gonna turn her on here so you can hear how it sounds, see what it looks like. Connect to my phone here.
Back with the remix. These boys are my sons like Phoenix. My city and state never ever seen this. Jimmy Neutron, I'm a young boy genius. On a full time, I'ma give it that penis. When it's just done, I'ma fill up arenas. Ooh, like Gilbert Arenas. Shoot my shot, I'm still with the demons. got five chicks in New York, that means one in each borough. I'm in the pocket like Burrow. When I'm back home, they treat me like Robert De Niro. Took her to talk about butter and churro. Took her home, gave her the cinnamon swirl. I left it in, I got 1 euro. Zeros on zeros on zeros. That's what my bank account balance say. I got a check from the shoe company, not do anything in the balance say.
Alright, so that's the last of this install. So I appreciate everybody that watched this. I'm planning on doing this on pretty much every single one that I do. You know, it's kind of a fun thing to do. It takes me longer to do things when I'm trying to video, and also it's hard for me to video exactly everything I'm doing, like in the process of wiring together the radio and stuff like that, just because I'm a one-man army. So if you have any suggestions on what I should try to do better at or whatever, just let me know in the comments, and I appreciate you watching. Thank you. I'll see you in the next one.